This summer, East London is the focus of the world. But there's more to this part of the capital than the Olympics. It's also produced some of this country's most outstanding musical talent. Now, three of those artists, Leona Lewis, Labrinth, and Pan B, are going back to their inner city roots.
It's hard to come from where we come from and just ignore the struggle you went through as a youth.
To try and inspire a group of teenagers whose lives are a long way away from the glamour of the Olympics.
Like these kids, they don't like themselves and they don't think that they're good enough to do positive things.
The three stars will be helping the kids to write tracks based on their own lives and then perform them on stage in Hackney in 3 weeks' time.
The possibilities are amazing. Like, you can change someone's life with this whole little situation that we have here.
It's all about the journey, it's not about the destination.
If I really truly believe in something and I risked everything for it, it's time for me to test myself and see actually how far I've come.
Doubt started growing from the ground like trees right up to the clouds, so profoundly seen.
Plan B, aka Ben Drew, has just 20 minutes before he performs his new single on Later with Jules.
See what I mean? It's not ending, it's not.
He's still writing it. With his first feature film about to be released, his third album in production, and a UK tour coming up, Ben Drew is a busy high achiever.
He needs another 4 bars.
But it wasn't always this way. Twelve years ago, none of Ben's success looked likely. He was thrown out of school and sent to the Tunmarsh Centre in East London, a pupil referral unit for kids unable to attend mainstream schools. And now he's going back.
I didn't feel ready to go back until I really felt like I had a cause, or I really felt like I could make a difference. I'm at that age, I've experienced enough. I could go into that school and plant some positive seeds inside some of these kids' heads, make them dream bigger.
Around 6,000 students a year in the UK are excluded from mainstream schools. Many are sent to a pupil referral unit, a PRU. The head teacher at Tunmarsh selected a group of young people that she thinks will get the most out of the star's influence. Most were excluded for disruptive or threatening behaviour.
I got blamed for bringing in a knife and a screwdriver.
At primary school?
Yeah.
Before coming to Tunmarsh, Joe was excluded from both primary and secondary schools for violent behaviour.
Normally our children, I think they have a series of challenges, one on top of each other.
When Courtney's dad died, she started getting into trouble.
I got kicked out of school. I got sent to Behaviour Improvement Project because I weren't allowed back into school. Then that closed down and they sent me to Tunmarsh.
You have a series of things that go wrong in your life, actually, your resilience does get weakened and you start maybe making the wrong choices.
I was proper angry because I never really did anything. It was just like a fake gun.
Godwill was excluded 2 months ago for taking a ball-bearing gun into school.
I wouldn't exactly come to school with a real gun, would I?
I don't know what teenager don't smoke or drink, like. Everyone smokes and drinks. It's just a way to get away from life, isn't it?
Kerri-Anne has been going to Tunmarsh for a year, but regularly doesn't show up for her course.
If a child's not coming to school, often there are issues within the family as well, and we try and support the family and encourage the child to come to school as much as possible. But yes, the children should be here.
I got into trouble a few times. Then I got kicked out. Well, look, I think I got moved. And then I got moved to Tunmarsh, too.
Having ADHD meant Justin's behaviour was difficult to manage in mainstream school.
Violence is like probably increased, but like people don't fight with fists anymore, like they use weapons and all that.
You can walk on a long road, never turn your back, and by the time you turn your back, you see 50 youths behind you. But you can still not be involved but get beat up.
Growing up amongst the gangs of Forest Gate, Clinton has always had a rocky school career.
That's the life I live. You have to make everything happen for yourself. Nothing's gonna come to you easy.
There are also kids at Tunmarsh that have been the victims of bullying or violent behaviour themselves.
They, like, one of the boys, they put me down on the floor, pushed me and they punched me, and then they picked me up and they slammed my head on the wall. That's what happened.
And bullying was the reason Rose became school phobic.
It started off mentally mostly, and then it did get kind of physical, like people throwing things at me and pushing me and stuff like that. I started to self-harm, so I had to see a counsellor. She referred that I should go to Tunmarsh Centre instead of being in a school, and that I shouldn't have to go back to a school again.
For all of them, Tunmarsh could be the last chance they have to get their education and lives back on track. At 15, Ben was excluded from school for throwing a chair at a teacher.
Yeah, 12 years, man. 12 years, a long time.
He arrived at Tunmarsh in 1999.
Do you remember you used to sort of really try and wind me up?
Do you remember those sick, twisted stories I used to write?
Yeah, I hated your story. Do you remember I said I loathe this story, but it's very good. I gave it an A, but I said it's revolting, it's revolting.
I don't know, I can't remember what it was.
Well, I can remember it.
I was just going for shock tactics.
You were? Yeah, it was all about snot-encrusted balls, thanks very much. It was revolting.
Ben's life was turned around when he was at Tunmarsh. Now he wants to help a group of teenagers to change theirs.
They're really excited. It's like one of your own coming back, one of your own that's made it and coming back.
Is this the class? Who's missing?
They'll be writing and performing music, although none of them have been chosen for their musical abilities.
So we need to do a song that you guys are going to perform in front of a lot of people. It's gonna be, like, scary.
How did you get famous?
Oh my God, oh my God!
I worked hard. I worked hard, it took me 10 years. For me, I never done anything for money. I never wrote a song for money, I never done a film for money.
You know? Still got money?
Yeah, money comes with it though. Mm. You know, for 10 years, I didn't have no money. It's only when my last record come out, which is the one you lot probably know, the Strictly Max one, yeah? That the money started coming. That whole process, that was 10 years of hard work. And you know, you're not gonna work at nothing that hard and put everything into it unless you're passionate about it and you love it, you know? I'm here to talk to you guys and for us to work out what we're gonna do in 3 weeks' time. If you guys are gonna have to perform, then we need to put the hard work in and get to know each other and feel comfortable around each other, you know? I'm dedicated, I'm here for you guys and I wanna make this work.
I knew he was famous. I didn't just think nothing, I knew he was famous, that's it.
Very nice person, polite.
It was actually alright. It was great. It looked different than when he was on TV.
In the classroom, when they're disrupting the class, if they're tapping into that juvenile energy, it's fun to fuck around, you know? And I think if we can just teach them how to channel that in the right place, like on the fucking stage, like channel that fun and that energy there, then it can live somewhere and it ain't got to live in the classroom anymore, you know?
Ladies and gentlemen, this is something they call a groundbreaker.
In this project, Ben's joining forces with two other big East End names, Labrinth and Leona Lewis. They're also going back to their old schools. Yeah, I was born in Stoke, Newington, Stoke. They're going back to remind themselves what made a difference to their lives when they were younger.
How you doing, bro?
It's so nice to go back inside.
And how they can use that to help the kids at Tunmarsh.
What's going on, bro?
Oh, man.
How have you been?
I'm all right, yeah.
I miss you, man.
I know, wow!
About our lessons.
You know, and you came with a very bad rep, and I can remember sitting you down and saying, I don't care what went on before, this is day one,
I want
you to go forward. And you did go forward.
Yeah, you did.
You know, and you were really good.
We worked it out.
He's on the rest of the school.
In school, it's like a crossroads in your life, like, really, like I had mentors in school, and that definitely definitely kind of opened my mind as a young person.
Oh my God! That is the wall. Like I was running and I fell over that wall and I've still got that scar.
I remember teaching this so much bigger than the
I think that for me, coming from somewhere with so many different people, from so many different backgrounds, I know I feel lucky to be brought up here.
I'm a survivor, I'm not a giver, I'm not gonna stop.
And that definitely reflects in everything like the style, the fashion here, the music here. There's a big clash, a big mashup of everything, and it produces something really special.
So listen, ladies and gentlemen, this is something they call a groundbreaker.
To have guidance or to have somebody that you think would be like you in school and say that this is not the way and there's better things out there for you, it's definitely very healthy. Like, you know, Plan B, Leona and stuff like that. To see these people come from the same place that you came from and become something totally different, it's definitely healthy and hopefully it'll be inspiring.
Ben's now spent time with most of the kids involved, so he's meeting with Leona and Labrinth to decide what they want to achieve and how they'll do it.
When I decided to do this, I thought it would just be as easy as walking, hear them do their thing, and then put them in a band,
Not at all.
We got like issues with a lot of the kids coming from really dysfunctional family backgrounds, so they're like kind of low on confidence, and you know, don't have a lot of belief in themselves. If you engage with these kids with something that they're already passionate about, right, and you accomplish something with music, then when they come back to school, you know, and they got to do an English test or a maths test, they're like, you know what, I can do this.
So have none of them performed before?
No, that's what I mean. It's like they roll up when they want to roll up as well.
Yeah, I'm going to be rehearsing a few weeks before. They can come down to like rehearsals see like, you know, us preparing. And I'm in the studio as well, if they want to come down to the studio. And
I'm not scared of it, but I'm just like, if they find one hint of this is not working, they kind of shut down. And it's like, how do you work with that? Because if they're on it 100%, then you're going to be rolling right to the end of it.
That's the challenge, because it's like, who knows what's going to happen?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's a little under 3 weeks before the kids have to perform on stage, and it's Ben's second day at the school.
Guys, right, do you know what? Can we all sit round the table? Is that all right?
To kickstart the creative process, he gathers the kids together to talk lyrics. But before he can get started, there's a surprise arrival. She's so keen to be involved in the project, school-phobic Rose has come into a class full of kids for the first time in 2 years.
You guys not all met? Have you not all met?
Right, everybody introduce yourself to Rose.
I'm from
Portugal.
You alright?
Alright. I was talking about kind of lyrics. This song is about my dad, My dad, abandoned me and my sister when I think I was about 6 or 8, I can't remember. I was young. I didn't know if he was alive or dead or nothing. My dad weren't violent, but he was mixed up. So I wrote this song.
I don't hate you, I don't love you neither. You mean nothing to me, just another geezer. I won't hit you, still I won't hug you either. If we ever meet again, cold is how I'm gonna treat ya. I don't hate you, I don't love you neither.
The reason I'm bringing this up, because this is me going deep, deep personal. This is me in front of you guys. I only met you yesterday. This is me, well, not just you guys, the whole world, because I put it on my album. This is me laying my cards on the table. This is me. This is my family. This is my dad. This is where I come from, yeah? And that's it, you know? What are you going to say? What's anyone going to say? Honesty is the key. You've got to be honest with yourself, and then you ain't got to never be ashamed of nothing. If we're going to perform a song, yeah, we can't be performing songs about money and hoes and cars and all that. So I'm not that kind of guy. I want you guys to write about your saddest ever moment and how you truthfully felt about it.
I've had problems I'd gone with the wrong friends, I started smoking kind of beers, and then my dad died. I don't speak to none of my mum's family. Like, she got a new boyfriend and like, she picked him, and then I ended up in care for it. Like, don't know, just now all I'm working on is to make my dad proud.
Okay.
My friend died, like, last week because he was walking with his gang members in there. Basically, someone just come and shanked him and all that. And, like, he said to me, yeah, before, like, one day I'm gonna give up this life and all that. And I said, good, innit? And, like, it's pretty sad, I don't know.
Yeah, it is.
Leona.
Mm-hmm. All right, man. Okay. Steve, all right. I'm looking at this little kid thinking, how old is he, like 13? And it's just like, I don't know, man. Like, one of my friends died, but we was 18, and like, that fucking hit me hard. I was 18 years old, he's 13, man. I mean, it's almost like their childhood's been taken away from them and they're being forced to be adults by people that are like only a couple years older than them, you know what I mean? You've got that side of society that believes they should be punished even further. And when you see someone like Jesus crying in the classroom, well, you think a little kid like that should be punished even further than he's already being punished. I don't know, man. Coming here, for me, it's not... It's bigger than the performance, because it's their life.
Now, with the kids inspired to write, the hard work can begin.
Hey, can we get a plug for that keyboard? Right, can you make a beat on that?
Yeah, I'm looking for it.
I need more help, man.
To give him a hand bringing out the musical talents in everyone, he's enlisted the help of some friends.
3, 2, 3, and...
I got a call from Ben yesterday, actually, and he said, I'm teaching in my old school. Do I want to come down and help him and meet some of the kids? I said, yeah.
All right. I say the same thing
twice. And also keen to get started is Labrinth.
Instead of trying to kind of enforce rules and be a teacher, because I'm not good at being a teacher and I'm not very good at speaking, I'd rather teach by just doing.
As somebody who's a producer as well as a performer,
what's going on, bro? Good?
Lab is introducing Jesus to the world of creating beats.
1, 2, 3, let's go now. You done? Oh, so what do you want to do?
I'll just like it stopped there.
And then something. Do do. I'll like do something at the end, like.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
So what's the song got to be about?
Real thing.
Kerri-Anne didn't turn up in time for Ben's first lyric session, so he's bringing her up to speed.
Things like gang culture, like when I'm sitting here and saying, like, why do you agree that it's all right to be in a gang? I want to know.
Like, I don't agree with the gangs, but some of them I do, like, because some gangs, yeah, people are in it to, like, make them feel more like family and, like, it makes you feel, like, more secure, I don't know.
Protected, like, innit?
Yeah.
You know why I was never in one? Because I thought, all right, so if you protect me, if you help me out, that means whenever you need something,
yeah,
whenever you need someone to hold some drugs for you or hold a gun, you're going to come to me and I won't be able to say no because I owe you. And then for the rest of my life, yeah, yeah, I'm going to be in debt to you.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, that's why I didn't get involved in it.
Hey, give me a drum loop.
Once they've got the words written, it's time to think about the music.
So you best come before the beat.
You best stay below the hill on your worst days. Cause if you come over the hill, it's your last days.
You best. No, listen. Leave the gap, sir. You best be below the hill when you're God's day. You best. The thing is, like, with these guys, when we perform live, they can't be going off beat. It sounds awful.
You best stay below the hill while your rest days.
You've got to be in time. Singers need to be in tune. Can't be clanging everywhere, like, that's standard, you know.
Man's walked with a ting in my right. Now louder. Stay below the hill while your last day. Cause if you come over the hill, it's your last day.
So I need you to practice that. An audience is not going to have it. You say, oh, these are some, you know, kids, you know, from PRU. People ain't going to say it's good just because they're underprivileged kids. Do you know what I mean? It's like, people are only going to say it's good if it's good.
But some of the kids are impressing Ben already. Godwill has already written the start of her first song.
So I said, I'll write a mid late. I was so impressed. It's just exceptional. The writing is exceptional.
Drop dummies in the end, we're gonna slap in blood. The inner eight for the most gonna drop in front. Plenty niggas say they're running cause they love the fame.
Clinton, his lyrics are like gangster lyrics, like straight up. He's probably, no, definitely better rapper than I was at that age, and I was a good rapper.
That Biggie Smalls or something,
yeah,
this kid.
Sick, blood.
Can't believe it. Some of the things you was talking about, I just wanted to know how you felt about them in reality. Do you know what I mean?
It's just lyrics, isn't it?
Your lyrics, your wordplay, so intelligent, bruv. All you've got to do to make it work for you is put a positive slant on it in some way. Because then it becomes art. Then it's not just you just spitting aggression. It just needs to have something positive at the end. You have to do it for a positive reason. Do you know what I mean? You need to start thinking about the bigger world outside of here. You know, and why so many kids like you and your friends are in the position they're in from the minute they're born. Why is that, bro?
I've always been in Forest Gate from when I was born till today. Police is everywhere, a lot of things happen, get stopped and searched on a regular basis. It's a lot of stress. In a normal day, there's just a lot of stress, to be honest. Excuse my language, but and it's fucked, innit?
You need to think about them things. You need to break it down. You could change things, man. You could do that with lyrics like that. Bro, you could do it.
We've got to make some more beats, bro.
Cool.
All right, once again.
In another room, Labrinth discovers Justin, who's never picked up drumsticks before.
You only learned today?
Yeah.
And you're already kind of mastering it?
Not really.
Are you liking it?
Yeah, but it's confusing though. But once you get into it, you can crush it a lot.
In my stomach there's a pain, see you walk in my direction and I go the other way.
But it's the kids that have less confidence that are becoming the focus of Ben's attention.
When somebody says your name. No. Oh yeah, sorry, my bad, carry on.
What are you saying?
No. Sorry, carry on, my bad. Courtney today, she wrote about her dad dying. In my stomach there's a pain, so you walk in my direction and I go the other way. She said, look, when I try and write about this subject, like, it brings up all these old emotions. I want the pain go away. It runs so deep.
My head's all... See, I can't. It's too low.
You ain't even tried it. Don't ever be afraid to fail. Because we learn so much from failing, right? Okay. What's happened to her is not fair, man. It's really heartbreaking and my dad wasn't there, but I had mum. I had a mum there and she ain't got a mum there, you know.
Oh, me and my mum just didn't get along. And then after my dad died, we just clashed. When I left at 12, I've never had a proper relationship with mum. I don't hardly ever talk to her. So.
I put your picture on my mirror. They're not all going to become singers, no, I know that. But she might become a poet. You know what I mean? She might become a songwriter. Or she might not become any of those things, but maybe this process is going to help her, like, as a person, help her grow up, help her deal with her issues in an adult way, in a correct way, you know? Because once she does that, then maybe she can actually sit down and say, what do I want to do in my life? Now I've got over that shit, what do I want to do in my life?
Like Courtney, a lot of the kids taking part in this project have not had an easy home life. When Leona was growing up, she had a large extended family to support her, who she says helped her to succeed. They still get together regularly at her Auntie Lorette's house.
I've always been really close to Auntie Lorette, like, just since I was little. She's the best.
We come from a big family.
Yeah.
And when Lee's here, Lee's Lee. She's not superstar Lee, she's Lee. Leona's very special. My mum was in hospital. She flew from wherever she was every week and she was down at that hospital. You know, and I remember one time we was in the You know, but it was so special and even like when she was on the X Factor, my mum watching her every single week, you know.
I get to see my cousins here and we all get to hang out and vibe and Auntie Lorette's just been amazing, like always, and yeah, family's just pretty important to me, so it's, you know, it's nice when I'm back home.
It's 5 days since Ben first arrived back at the school.
Well, everything's going really well. I'm really pleased. It's wonderful to see the children, young people engaged, happy, listen to what he's saying. It's brilliant that the kids are enjoying it. It's exactly what we wanted.
I really respect him. He's been in the same position as us. He understands, he talks to us as a person, like a friend.
He doesn't treat us like we're just immature and stupid. He shows us how...
He comes across like he's one of our friends, and we can tell him
something. Although they're beginning to enjoy the process, the kids will have to perform their tracks at the Radio 1 Academy in Hackney in just over 2 weeks.
The fact that they've got to perform on June the 1st is really starting to hit me now. And, you know, it could do more harm than good if we don't properly prepare them.
Ben's music classes are having a big impact on school life, and not just in a good way. The kids who are not involved are starting to get frustrated. So Ben decides to move to a rehearsal studio.
What a bloody bastard.
Why are you picking on me?
Come out, goodbye.
Trips out of school like this are rare at Tunmarsh because some of the kids have serious behavioural issues. But Ben's hoping that getting him out of the school environment and playing with his own band will build their confidence both musically and personally.
My name's Crazy Skull, I'm always jamming in the blocks, chilling with the chicks instead of shotting the rocks, because if I get blocks, I'm going to end up getting...
They got short attention spans, so it's like we've got to teach them without using words. And the best way of teaching kids without words is experience. They come and play with my bands. They know what it feels like to be part of a unit where you can rely on the people around you, Whereas if I just put them all in a band and give them instruments, they're going to hold each other back.
Despite the opportunity to rehearse with a band...
Hey, Kieron.
For the second day running, Kieron hasn't turned up.
Listen, Kerry, you weren't there yesterday, so I figured yesterday you'd just be practicing. You're not here today. You need to practice. You need to know it off by heart. It's only a simple rhyme, it's one verse. It's inevitable that some of them are going to fall by the wayside. I'm not going to stop trying to pour positivity into her and making her believe that she can be something. I ain't going to stop doing that. You know Leona Lewis is coming tomorrow. Did you hear that?
Oh my God.
She's coming tomorrow. Ah, you're definitely there tomorrow, all right.
And true to her word, when Leona arrives at the studio, Kieron's there.
What's your name?
Kieron.
Hi, nice to meet you. You all right? What's your name?
Goodwill.
Nice to meet you, Leona.
Sweetie.
Rose
is also there. I'm not
finally, getting to sit down with them, hearing their songs. It was fun working on the best bits and bringing that out of them.
Should I run?
The thing is, once I got their attention on focusing on something, it kind of easily becomes a bit boring and we want to try something new. So it's about really making it fun, but, you know, giving it a sense of purpose because we're doing this for a reason, you know, and at the end of it, there's a performance that I want them to feel confident in.
Can we do that chorus once again?
It might be nice
to do a harmony if you can find it.
Wanna try it?
Okay.
But while Leona works with the other girls, Kieron is feeling underprepared. Faced with singing with Leona, her confidence seems to have disappeared. And Ben's concerned she's going to drop out.
It's not that you ain't good enough, it's that you ain't put the work in.
No part.
Imagine if you'd come, like, I would have prepared you so well. You see how Rose and Scruffle doing their thing, yeah? I would have prepared you so well, man. So what have you learned? What have you learned that you failed and you can't do something, so or you didn't practice and you need to work harder?
I failed and I can't do it.
Right, well, that's probably why you ain't turning up, because you already think that before you've even tried to do anything. And I don't know why you think that. I don't know why you have that attitude. I don't know who's telling you you're not good enough, but they're chatting shit. Why do you have that attitude yourself? Stems from something. It's probably the same reason why you're in Tumwash and all. Isn't it? Same reason why you didn't want to work at school.
I used to be a really bright child, like, I used to do my work. All these certificates have been achieved by, there was something called the merit system, where if you get, like, 150 merits, you get a bronze. That's for achieving 20, that's 50, 90, like, and when you get, like, big ones, like 200 merits, you get a letter home. I got a folder, and it's got, like, loads of poems that I've written myself, because my teacher used to encourage me, and she gave me a book, and she said that every time you write a poem, put it in there. So I used to be a real good girl, but you know, when I come to this new borough, I kind of turned a bit bad.
You ready, Jesus?
I'm free.
Let's keep rolling.
One.
They call me a terrorist, dangerous to the government. But you know what? I don't think it's relevant. I might be young, but I'm not dumb.
Well, degenerate, yeah, okay.
The boys are at a recording studio with Lab.
Find a hideout.
Yep.
When you see me wild out.
That's the one.
Or you'll find out.
Yeah, just keep rolling, don't worry.
While the girls are with Ben.
If you want a party, don't jump.
He wants them all to record their tracks so they can take them home to practice singing the tunes. To learn their lyrics. And improve their timing.
When you see me wild out, see where it? Or you're gonna find out. Yeah, yeah. You better find a hideout. Oh, come on.
When you see me wild out.
That's the vibe.
Or you're gonna find a hideout.
So, or you're gonna find. It's just on that last one. So, or you're gonna. Right now, I feel a little bit nervous. I gotta be honest. Because, like Plan said, it's well underdeveloped. Like, some of them have never even been in the studio before. Some of them don't even understand the concept of rhythm, and they're still working that out.
At the girls' recording studio, Courtney has received a phone call that's unsettled her, and she wants to go home.
You need to start doing stuff for you, making yourself happy. I understand your situation, and you know what? You're in a worse off situation than I ever was. But it still affected me, the situation I was in. So I feel for you.
This is the thing, in life, you still have to deal with all that other personal shit. It's always going to happen, but you need to know that your work is the only thing that's going to make your life better. If you're in like an industry like this, it's like no matter what's going on, that's the only positive thing that's going to change all that other shit.
I understand. I know what you mean, but just if we just chill as much as possible.
At the boys' studio, there's also a problem.
I want you to stay here. I want you to be in part of this experience. So just like for now, just be cool. Like.
Ibrahim has had a standoff with his teacher and stormed out of the studio.
Just be respectful and don't embarrass her in front of everybody else and stuff like that, you know what I mean? You know, just stay cool, that's it. You know what I mean? Let's get this track rolling, let's have some fun. Let's get as much out of the experience, you know what I mean? I feel you though, bruv. Let's go.
Everything they are is a product of their environment. Everything.
One, two, three, snitch, you get snitched.
Snitch, you get dropped.
Yeah. They have every opportunity to come out of it, but it's whether it looks cool enough. And it's almost like me and Plan have to make the idea of being something successful or something positive as cool as it could ever look, if you get what I mean. Because right now, to them, it's like to be in the slums and to be ghetto is a cool thing. And I'm like, it's not really, mate.
After 5 hours in the studio, Courtney's gone home and the other girls have totally lost interest.
So all I'm doing is trying something, and if you hate it, then we'll try something else, but the song needs a minute late.
Okay. Ben's also tired, as he's been up all night recording his own album.
I should be working on my single right now, like, and that to come out and it be successful, it needs to be finished. Instead, I'm doing this.
This is getting boring now.
I committed myself to this. If I commit myself to something, then I'll do it 110%. But the difficulty is, like, when the kids are coming in here and they're not putting the effort in, my career is basically fucking up now.
And to make matters worse, Ben hears from the head teacher that the kids have been skipping lessons. So he calls them all together.
Right, listen, yeah, you lot have been working hard, you've all been improving. But you see, what I do, it's hard work, and I don't think all of you understand how hard it is. You have to work hard at it, because yeah, it's hard, and it's grueling, and it's tiring, but if you get to the other end, if you get through it, it will pay off. And there is a society out there that have already judged you lot. They already think you're stupid and that you can't achieve nothing because of where you're from. And when you come out of the school and when you go out there and you start trying to work, you'll meet the people I'm talking about, because they'll make you feel this big. Because they come from a place where they had a good education, they had a nice family upbringing and they had money.
and they will look at you like you're scum. And when you talk, they'll laugh at the way you talk because it's not as intelligent and articulate as them. The reason I'm in this school now is to prove that you lot are just as capable as the rest of them. That's what I'm trying to prove. But like then when I leave here and you ain't doing the right thing, all that means is I'm failing. I'm failing. And you're failing yourselves. And you're proving all them people out there that think you're stupid right. And they ain't right.
The performance is now only a week away.
You're a group now. When you're on that stage, I can't help you.
Rehearsals step up a gear.
I feel like there just needs to be something else. I can't just be good now. It has to be amazing.
I need energy. I need you to be like, you know, moving to the beat. To you looking like you want to be here. I need to see it now, though.
Because you're just, like, a little bit above the note.
You'll feel it after the gig when no one's coming up to you and saying, oh, good gig, and they're saying it to everybody else. If things go wrong, it can really mess up your confidence, you know? It's hard to come back from that. I'll be there to help you come back from that if things go wrong, you know what I mean? I ain't just going to disappear.
You better look at your audience, bruv, man. They want to believe in what you're saying. If you believe in what you're saying, then, you know, they will believe in what you're saying. To kind of keep getting them to do it over and over again is like, even for me, it's stressful.
It is easy to get bored. 14 years old, like, you know, you don't want to do things 100 times, but if they want to do the show, they're going to have to step up.
50% better than the first time, but you can go 50% more than that.
It's made me feel like I can do something. And plus, yeah, just to do this, I've been, like, waking up early, going to bed early. So it's a real change.
The time and effort Ben, Labrinth and Leona are putting in...
Can I go now?
..is finally starting to pay off.
Cool. Done.
It was, like, a big step for me to come into school because I haven't actually been around or other kids for, like, around 2 years. There's been a few times where I've been a bit like, oh, I can't do this, but then I realised that I'm where I want to be at the moment, and so I'm just trying to enjoy it.
Yeah. At the end of the session with Leona, Courtney brings out a poem she's written about her dad.
Every Saturday, you used to take me to the park. Once I fell over, I swear I still have that mark. You picked me up and cuddled me tight. Dad, this is how I let you know I'm doing all right. It's hard without you, I must admit, with all that's going on, Dad, I would never quit. You're a star, a twinkle in my eye, because when I need you, I look to the sky, and then the last bit will go, Daddy, I love you. When God took you, I felt so much pain, but I would live this life over and over again.
Oh, that's beautiful. That's really beautiful. Yeah. Do you want to put out your music?
Yeah.
So let's work out some kind of melody.
Mm-hmm.
Courtney's poem really, really touched me. It was really just so deep and coming from the heart.
I need you. All I have to do is da-da-da-da.
Such a young girl, and I'm so glad that she is able to express herself like that.
Ba-da-da-da. And I'll just sit to the sky.
I feel like kids should just be protected and, you know, not have to go through things like that. And I don't know, like, to have music to express yourself or poems or however you can express yourself and get it out, I think it's so much better than kind of letting it sit inside and kind of fester. And, yeah, it's just a really, I was really emotional.
Well, I need
with you. All I wanna do is close my eyes. Oh, I wanna see you. Wanna wrap my arms around you. So I look up to the sky.
It's now 2 days till the performance, and the kids have their first and last chance to go through their songs together as a group.
And of course, nobody's done a performance before, so as soon as the big day comes, it's going to be like, oh. Are you ready, Mr. Joe?
But when the boys get onto the stage, there appears to be a problem.
Okay, you ready, Joe? You ready, Joe? Where's Jesus? My name's... ramming in the blocks. What's happened?
And that problem is the girls.
I know, we're going to get Jesus. We're going to try this one more time. We're going to try this one more time.
The boys are intimidated by them.
They're all annoying me, especially Godwin.
Why? What's been happening?
She's keep giving me dirty looks and putting me down. Yeah, Jesus beats, yeah, right.
Yeah, she keeps saying stuff like that.
Yeah.
The girls scare the boys to death. The boys like lose all of their confidence as soon as the girls are like there. I could see that. Because Joe was fully on it yesterday, and then I just saw him just looking at the girls while he was doing his lyrics. I was like, whoa. 1 second before you perform, come and sit down. I need everyone to sit down, and let's sit down in a circle. Everyone performed, and you guys were sick, and you guys got talent, everyone's got skills, but the only thing I didn't see was the support between all the groups, yeah? You guys are basically doing this whole show together. So I need to see everybody supporting everyone. If one person's not doing so well, then everybody fails. We're all in it together, like, this whole show is everybody's show together. We're a team now, in this room. I think they get it, but they will only really get it when they're performing. Like, I think they don't understand how scary it will feel for them. Right now, they've gotten used to all the people around right now, so it's easy to go up on stage and do their thing, but it's gonna be fresh air, it's fresh people. I'm hoping that they will be fully confident, and this is all we can do, really, to prepare them for it.
Finally, it's the day of the performance.
Are you nervous?
Of course. No, I don't know. No, I don't know.
Come on, wipe me out!
Everybody who's been part of this whole process has got so emotionally entangled in it, and it's just been such a massive journey. And for the individuals, you know, there's so much riding on it for them.
Are we going to park this in a garage and then turn up in a better one?
They'll be performing on stage at the Radio 1 Academy in Hackney. And while the kids seem to be up for it... it's Ben who's really feeling the pressure.
I can't believe you're actually constructing a clique right now.
We did not have this yesterday.
Listen. This was all here, because when I left you lot, I left it all in place. All the fucking stems, all the shit was there.
This is embarrassing.
So,
now...
are you not going to do it?
We are going to do it.
And at the dressing rooms...
we don't have enough of the stuff, yeah?
It doesn't get any better.
I know, look, I'll get all that. Relax about that, yeah? But these will fit me, so they'll fit you. You got to take these shorts off first, you know that, right? Now, listen, guys, what you should all be doing right now is you should be focusing on what you got to do. So you need to keep on running it over and over in your head right now. I do this for a living, trust me. When you get in there and you see all them people, you're going to be nervous. But it's okay, as long as you stay focused and you remember what you've got to do.
The audience is made up of friends, family, the whole of Tunmarsh, and other kids from East London schools.
I'm nervous. Yeah, but you know, we've run out of time now, so I'm just hoping that, you know, I hope they all know what they're doing.
Well, guys, so let me introduce Plan B.
guys, thanks for coming today. About a month ago, I went back to my old school, Tamworth Centre, in Blasto. That school changed my life. But when I came back to the school 4 weeks ago, I wanted to use music as a kind of therapy to get the kids there to express themselves. Hopefully when you watch the show, you're going to see how far they've come. So our first act up today is Jesus Beats, Justin Beats, and your man Slinky.
Go with something, cuz we got beef, so then ooh, we gon' be something, cuz enough drama going on, we got us nothing, blood there in the eight, but the roads is gonna drop it, crap.
Clinton looked like a proper rapper, man. He looked like a proper star.
You know when I slip,
he just had energy and he had swagger and he had attitude.
I'm Justin's mum, I'm fantastic. I can't just believe. I feel like he's only learned it in a week. I'm over the moon with him.
I have to go and buy him a set of drums.
I'm trapped in today and there's no way out. I keep saying I'ma feel like I know it without a doubt. Trying to get out of a hole that I fell down a couple years ago. But there's so much left to say, they're saying it's a no-go.
Rose, I think she doesn't sound like a little kid rapping. Like, she's talking about adult stuff and she's doing it well.
I'm gonna cry. I guess her mind's so broke that things will never go right. I'm out of sight, I'm out of mind.
No, Joe definitely smashed it.
You better find a hideout. When you see me wild out, or you're gonna find out the hard way when I put
Joe's flow was tight.
You don't wanna come round it, it gets fun round it, it's not fun round it.
It was confident.
I'm proud. Yeah, he's come a long way, so yeah, I'm happy.
Well, she's written a poem, and I think it's going to move everyone in the audience. It comes from a really deep and emotional place, and I think she's got a lot of strength to come and do it today.
Every Saturday, you would take me to the park. Once I fell over, I swear I still have that mark. You picked me up and you held me tight, and this is to let you know that I'm doing all right. It's hard without you, I must admit, but somehow you keep me strong. So for you, I'd never quit. Although I miss you, Dad, I'll be fine. We'll meet again, just at the end of time. Just watch, Dad, from a great height. I'm gonna make it and do good with my life.
Anything, I really want to see if it's made their life better, accepting some of the things in their life that have been really holding them back. I feel that's the biggest accomplishment.
And I gotta run somewhere else, cause I can't take no more of this. Yeah.
Godwill was exceptional today. Like, she's always been good, but I don't think she's been exceptional until today.
But
happy man.
they've just done amazing. Like, I did feel emotional, I felt myself welling up, because every single one of them went up there and they stood there and it was like, I'm gonna sing my song. And I was just like, yes, thank you so much.
He said I was his wife, he's a lie. I knew it was a lie, cause he didn't treat me nicely. He said he'll be there for me, but now I'm all alone. He said he'll never leave me on his cold, cold road. But now he's gone.
Kieron, she performed so confidently and so well, and her flow was so tight, and the projection of her voice was amazing.
He was a perfect boy to my heart around the city. And he made me smile every time he called me pretty. He was a perfect boy.
They did so good. I was so nervous, I was shaking for them. Like, that is worse than when I go and perform. So. But they did amazing. So proud of them.
Went better than I could have imagined. Like, everybody's just inspiring each other, and it's this constant circle of positivity.
Guys, I'd like you to take a bow for your audience, because you were amazing tonight.
I just, to be honest, I've fallen in love with these kids
Thank you.
And
thank you for being a great crowd. That is the end of the show.
They're that talented, and I believe in them so much that I'm still going to be here in 4 years' time wanting to know what they're up to. I know this whole thing's been worth it, and today was the proof.